Today we're visiting with Vern and Janine Husa. They've been members at Hope United Methodist Church for 38 years, and they're going to talk to us a little bit about their memories of the church. Can you tell me when or how you first heard about the Christian community we know as Hope United Methodist Church?
Yes, and Janine can handle that one very easily.
Good.
Well, we were looking for a home, and I was driving around with a realtor that said, we looked at this house and liked it, but he had some others to show us, and so we drove down Dayton, drove past the church being constructed at that time. It was just a muddy mess with a little bit of a foundation, and he said, oh yeah, they're building a Methodist church right here. I said, oh, I think that house back there is the one that we need. And so we knew that, the church was going to be there for us, and we went ahead and made the deal here.
Were you Methodist before you went to Hope Church?
Yes, we were.
I'll tackle that one. I started off a small farm church, Methodist Church in Lewiston, Nebraska, and then Janine and I got married 57 years ago in the Holmesville United Brethren Church, correct? And then I convinced her that we Methodists are better people, and so from there we started in Omaha, Ralston, Nebraska, had Methodist Church there, and then we went to Kansas City, and then from Kansas City we went to New Jersey, and then from New Jersey we came out here, and you've heard the story about how we found our current church. So yeah, we've been Methodists for a long time, and we have two children who were raised in the great youth segment of our church.
Yeah. Well, was there a building there when you moved into this house? Or are they just starting to build it?
It was just a hole in the ground.
Yeah. So the first time you worshipped was at the school?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Tell us what you remember about that.
Oh, yes. Coal. Because we've gone now from coal to a bird. To kind of give you a... Yes. Over the number of 10 ministers that we've had.
You're talking about Bob
Cole. Speaking of ministers, you didn't ask the question, but ministers are a lot like our daily lives. There are good days, and then there are some days that aren't quite as good, and I can draw a parallelism with some of our ministers.
Yes.
And some have been good, and some have been not as good. But there was a question you asked me, Charlie.
Yeah, Bob Cole was the pastor when they were meeting
at
the school.
Oh, yes, and we can remember going there, and what was the young man's name?
Sam Bruton.
Sam Bruton was just a young man, and he sat on some hymnals so that he could, I guess, reach the keyboard and still operate the piano. That's one of the first things that we remember about the church.
What was the worship service like at the school?
Well, Bob Cole was a big eye-opener to us because he wore sort of a white, off-white burlap minister's robe with a real rope
or a
belt. And we had never seen anything like that before, but it was the people that drew us to the church. And probably one of the reasons that we went there to start with was because the first day we lived in our house here, Kelly Wilson, who was Ann and Jack's daughter, and they were neighbors here in Sundance. Kelly came to the door with a dahlia, which happens to be one of my favorite flowers, and she had a bouquet of dahlias that she had picked from their own yard and brought it over to welcome us to the neighborhood and offer her services as babysitter if we ever needed someone. And that just kind of drew us in, and we were so impressed that they were at the church the Sunday that we went there. And I think that cemented us going to the church. So it's the people that draw us to the church rather than the ministers.
Well, you mentioned how Bob Cole was dressed. Do you remember what his sermons were about?
No, I don't. Do you?
Sorry about that. I might have dozed off maybe or something.
And how long did you worship at the school before the building was built there on the corner of Dayton and Bellevue.
About a year, don't you think?
I would say a year.
Something like that, yeah.
And after Bob Cole, visitation minister Victor Schult came to Hope. Do you remember Victor?
Yes, he was an old minister, same age as we are now, old. He was a great guy. He and his wife were just so friendly, and it was just, he was just a nice man.
Yep. I think he had retired and then came back to help with this new church they were doing there. Well, you remember moving into what's now the Schult Fellowship Hall as the original building?
Yes.
What was that like?
Well, since we had moved around from small churches in our career, it wasn't scary or shocking. It was just kind of good to get back into a church. And it was a nice church. We were pleasantly surprised.
Some people have said that it felt more like a community church as opposed to what I call high church, which is very formal and very litany-oriented. And I think that Hope's always been sort of friendly like that.
Yes, it reminded us of our churches in Kansas City and Nebraska. And yes.
They had it. They always set it up every Sunday morning in just rows of chairs in the fellowship hall. And everybody already, you know, established their place of where they were going to sit.
Yes.
And
like we still do.
Yes.
For those of you in the second service, you don't know, we go to the first service and we have a usual spot there. Go ahead, Charlie.
My grandmother sat in the same pew, the same place for years and years and years, and everybody knew that was her spot.
Well, I think we all kind of fall into that process.
Well, after Vic Schult came as the visitation minister, Bob Cole resigned, and Alton Brown was appointed as the pastor. Do you remember Al Brown?
Yes, Al Brown with his smoking pipe.
Yes.
And he was a good man. We enjoyed him, and he was just a down-to-earth, I think he was originally from Oklahoma, and he was just a down-to-earth guy. No, we enjoyed him. He had a sense of humor and a good sermon, and,
that's probably one of the times that we became the most involved in the church, because that's when, you know, everything took place in the little office area. That was also the kitchen and the office and the room that you worked out of whenever you went up there. And
yes.
That's, you know, I guess it was probably because of the congregation. We had little community dinners where everybody brought something, and like we had a community Thanksgiving dinner that everybody participated in. It wasn't on Thanksgiving, it was like the Sunday before or something like that, and everybody was assigned a certain thing to bring, and it was just really fun to see everybody participate and enjoy each other so much. We got to know other people so much more intimately than we would if that hadn't happened.
Yes. Well, some people have mentioned problems or issues with the new church. The parking lot was dirt, I believe, and when it would rain or get too much water, the basement would flood, and had all kind of issues just getting the building up and functioning. Do you remember any special things about that Fellowship Hall, which was the original building?
Yes, after rains, there was considerable flooding, and I don't remember the janitor's name or who was in charge, but he spent a lot of time trying to prevent the water from damaging the church. He worked his tail off. He was a good person, and I remember those days.
Well, over the years, you've been involved in a lot of different things at the church. Can you tell us some of the things that you've done for Hope?
Well, I was with a great ushering team. One of those persons is still a member at our church. And Janine was probably more active than I was. So, Janine, what all did you do?
Well, I was on the new member committee, and so worked with the new member classes, which You know, in those days, new member classes were more than just an hour or two on a Sunday afternoon. We had, I think it was probably a four-week session during Sunday school hour that we worked with people and helped them get acquainted with each other and with the church. And we had a lot of people that came in at that time. And so I helped with that. I worked on the evangelism committee. I was helped with Bible school. I helped with, I was on the ad board for a while. One of the ways you can find out what's going on in the church is to be on the ad board. And helped out with things like that, but probably the thing that we feel like we helped out with the most was making the coffee for Sunday morning. And Vern was probably more active in that than I was, because he was a jogger and he would go down and plug in the coffee on Sunday morning bright and early, so that when the ministers came to church, the coffee would be ready. And why don't you take it from there?
We did it for 18 years, and I have to admit it was sort of fun. Sam Day kept us motivated, because on Saturday night we'd be setting up and he'd always come in and lean over the counter, and you can't relate to that style of how the church was like then. But he'd always come in and say, well, I'll take a couple eggs over easy. And he had a good sense of humor. So 18 years we were there. Also, another thing we did as a family, we played on the Hope softball team. So our two children, growing children, and us, we weren't outstanding, but we thought we were great. Kelly Mahoney,
And Brooke
were good ball players. They were a lot younger than us, but
their boys were babies at that time, so it was just as much fun to hold a baby during the game
sure.
as it was to play, but we all played and had a great time.
And your kids were raised in the church. You have memories about their activities there?
Yes, they were active in the youth, and our son Kent was married by Sam Day at the church, and then our daughter, who moved to San Francisco and then came back and was married by Sam in the Estes Park area. So we were a little biased for Sam. He's a pretty good guy.
Sharon and I would agree he married us.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, we loved him.
Now, back to the new member classes. At the finale of the new member class, they used to have the class over to their house for like a dessert type reception before they joined the church, and that was always fun to go to their house. And
Sam and Barbara, his wife,
yes, Barbara.
Yeah, she was very active with that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, they kept us active.
Well, after Al Brown was the pastor, Dr. Richard Vickery was appointed as the senior pastor. Do you remember Dr. Vickery?
Not really. Not that much. No. Huh?
We remember all those names, but some of them didn't make an impression on us like Sam did.
Yes. Well, and Sam followed Dr. Vickery as the senior pastor and was there for some time. Other things you remember about Sam Day?
Well, yes. Probably the most remarkable thing was when Janine went in for brain surgery, and Sam came to the hospital and sat with me during the surgery, and it was really nice. It was really, really
I didn't know that.
Touching, yeah. That was a characteristic of Sam, and yeah, there's reasons for we're biased, because he helped us get through some tough times.
Sure. Well, after Sam Day was there, Margaret Hankins came to Hope. You remember Margaret?
Yes, very nice lady. Very nice lady, soft-spoken. And Janine had breast cancer surgery during her time. And to this day, she still asks Janine how she's doing. I just think it's unbelievable that Margaret can remember those details, because in a church as a pastor, you have a lot of things on your memory.
Yes.
She's a good person.
A very caring person.
Very good person.
Well, she was one of the first female pastors in Colorado Methodist churches. Did it bother you that she was a female?
No, not at all, because I mentioned back in Nebraska, Lewiston, my farm town, our small church had a female minister, and that was no big deal to me. As I've learned after my 57 years with Janine, women can be and are pretty sharp cookies. They can keep the congregation in line, and they can keep their husbands in line, too.
Absolutely.
And that's factual.
Well, with Margaret Hankins, John Lee served for a while as the co-pastor. Do you remember John Lee?
Yes, but not a lot of detail on him.
Yeah. And then Steve Miller also served with Margaret Hankins. Do you remember Steve Miller as a pastor?
Yes, but not a lot of comments on him.
As far as I'm concerned, John and Steve were so contrast to each other.
Yes.
It's Margaret had to really be flexible herself to have worked with both of those people and seemingly got along with both of them.
And that's another good example of women. I'm a believer in women.
You know, we're recording this. This is going to be good.
No, it's factual. My wife has kept me going for years.
Well, you've told us some of the things already, but you've been a member of this church for 38 years. Tell us a little bit what this church has meant to you and to your family.
I think that we've already spoken a lot of comments on our participation. Yeah, it's been up and down. Our children being involved, being married by Sam, and overall, yeah, there's been a couple times that we've gone to different churches because we're concerned, upset, frustrated. But it's like I said earlier, it's like our daily lives. There are good times and bad times and shaky times. And no, it's been a positive trend line with our church.
Yes?
I think the church to us is the people and the congregation and what it offers, like, you know, we have had so much talent in the music department.
Oh, man,
and
yes.
So many wonderful experiences listening to the music. And the, you know, I'm sure we're not the only ones that remember the Peggy Merlin bantering that they used to do. You know, that's something that will be embedded in all of our memories forever. And something that we enjoyed, and being friends with their both of the families and so many of the other families that were there. And when we think of the church, we don't think of a lot of the ministers. We just think of the friends that we have and the people and the things that have been so meaningful to us, and the Christmas Eve services and, you know, things like that, that, yeah, we would go there for the Christmas Eve service, but we would also go there for the fellowship after the Christmas Eve service and see, like, Scott Hansen that would come back from California.
Yeah.
We would, you know, wait for each other in the foyer to see him and people that we hadn't seen for a while. Carrie Bender would come back. So it was always really fun to, the people are the important part of the church. Somebody said to me one time, well, because we were saying something negative about one of the ministers, and she said, well, the thing we have to remember is we will last a lot here, a lot longer than that minister will.
Yes.
So.
Tell me what you like best about Hope Church.
Well, I think I just did.
Yeah.
But throw the soloists we have at our church and the brass band, the choir, Cheryl on the organ. There's a lot of talent. I've even heard you sing, Charles. You're not too shabby yourself.
Don't include me with those sterling members.
No. It's been a good time with the church.
Well, you've been a member of Hope United Methodist Church for 38 years. What would you like to see Hope accomplish in the next 38 years?
Well, we're concerned because we've got to keep that youth group going, because that's where the future is. And that sounds like a trite expression, but it is, because we know with our own family and their children, Sundays now have turned into soccer, baseball, football, you name it, sports. And so therefore, the family is being divided, not divided, but drawn away from Sundays and going to church, because they're going to games here, there, and everywhere. And we're concerned that our membership is aging. We're a good example of that. And we're seeing now with the combined service during the summer months that there are a lot of youth and young, cute little kids up there that you're taking pictures of and putting out there on internet. But we're concerned that churches are losing some strength, and we're concerned about our church, the future of our church, because with all the apartments being built up here and all the new houses, you would think the churches would be overloaded, but no, they're not. That's our concern, the future of all churches, religion.
There must be a concern of yours too, or you wouldn't be doing what you're doing with the Sunday school.
Yes.
I don't know the answer to it. I really don't. I wish we could come up with a magic idea, but good ministry, good ministers and choirs, and we've got to get some members active, bring them in and keep them there.
Yeah, I agree with you, and Sharon and I have been encouraged with the one service this summer, because we have seen a lot of young families didn't know.
Oh, yes.
They didn't come to the early service, so we didn't see them, or we didn't know them.
So there's encouragement there, but
we need more.
That trend line is not going the way we'd like it to.
Yes. Well, we talked about a lot of special people and times and events at the church. Are there other memories or things that we didn't talk about?
Well, I did have some crib notes here, just in case you were asked a tough question.
Good.
No, I think you've done a good job of monitoring Jenny and me to keep this presentation moving along at a fast pace. No, I think that we've covered the highlights. We're going to stay at this church and literally till the end, because we have our plans made in the Memorial Garden, and it's the future, but you got to accept it. So we'll enjoy today, and hopefully tomorrow and a few more years before we pack it in. Oh. That's about it. Yeah. Right, Janine, anything else?
I think you've covered it.
You've done a good job on this, Charlie. We'll give a couple stars on this.
Well, thank you very much for this interview. Appreciate your time this morning, and we'll see you in church.
Yes, that's right. Thank you.